The Marcos administration has given the green light to its first public-private partnership project, a 6 billion peso, 300-bed capacity cancer center at the UPPGH. The project will be structured as a 30-year build-operate-transfer arrangement. Joining us now is Engineer Reiner Hamande, co-chairperson of the Infrastructure and Logistics Committee of the American Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines. Reiner, thank you so much for joining us. Hi.
Good morning, Mimi.
Good morning. So, Reiner, before anything else, you were part of the team that built a COVID-19 hospital in Santa Rosa, Laguna in a record 27 working days, correct?
Yes.
Okay, for those wondering, you are a quantity surveyor and you essentially estimate and control costs for these large construction projects and make sure that these meet legal and quality standards. What are some of the big projects that you've handled so far?
I've done more than 600 projects worth of $50 billion. You know, when you estimate these kinds of projects, you get a lot of insights on how to manage it, right? So in 2017, we were having like 50 projects in a year. Mm-hmm. So, you know, probably that's something that we can share with you this morning.
So this, you have this expertise and you've seen so many of these projects in the Philippines. What are your thoughts on the Philippines infrastructure and logistics industry?
Okay. Well, first thing, we talked about inflation a while ago. Mm-hmm. And the inflation of material costs slowed down construction. In fact, this year, we're seeing some slowdown construction.
Okay.
But I would always preach that, you know, doing construction during a recession year has its own advantages.
Really?
Right? When,
okay.
Yeah. When the construction can actually sustain a portion of the demand to get the supply chain going, a lot of the contractors are actually out of jobs. So you can actually negotiate, you know, a better, you know, construction contract. Mm-hmm. You know, so again, there's some advantages. Of course, a lot of people will be hurting. And the current administration, you know, when they're talking about enabling environment for social and economic transformation, focus on job creation and poverty reduction. I think construction actually will have a big chunk of that job creation.
Mm-hmm. All right. Speaking of the government infrastructure push, out of the record 5.3 trillion peso budget for this year, 1/5, 20%, or 1.196 trillion is allocated for infrastructure programs for Marcos's Build Better More initiative. What do you think about the major infrastructure projects lined up for this year? I mean, I look at the list and you see what? Names like the North-South Commuter Railway, Metro Manila Subway, we're all excited for that, LRT 1 Cavite Extension. Are there certain projects that you feel can be dropped for now and certain projects that you think must be prioritized and inserted, based on your expertise in cost and quality?
All the projects that are lined up right now are really good projects. Mm. But we also need to take in mind that, you know, the private sector should also embrace this long-term goals. So we just saw the PGH partner with the private sector to also develop, you know, healthcare projects. The commuter rail and all the transportation projects, those are very welcome projects. But we also have to realize that a lot of the infrastructure should actually go to the countryside, because the only way to decongest Metro Manila is actually get those infrastructure available in the provinces. Mm-hmm. So that we don't have to pull in all the human resources into Metro Manila.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And you know, Engineer Reiner, I was... it's not just about the quantity or having these projects out there. It's also about the quality of these projects. And here I want to pull in a 2020 study by the IMF that showed the Philippines in general lags behind peers in the region when it comes to quality of infrastructure. I think we have a picture of this. I'm not sure if you can see the graphics. There you go. The blue one represents Philippine projects. The red one represents emerging markets peers in Asia. And the closer we are to number one in the middle, the lower the grading is. The worst it is, and the closer we are to the outer band, or number seven, the higher the ranking. Obviously, we're down in all of the aspects. Worst in railroad, in roads, in ports, air transport, electricity doing so-so, as well as fixed telephone lines. What are some of your key recommendations to make the quality of our infrastructure projects at par, either on the cost side or the quality side? And so they address the right issues.
First, I address cost because that's my expertise, right?
Okay.
The government has to have a very efficient cost of capital, use of capital. We're spending so much trillions of pesos in infrastructure. We have to have a very efficient use of capital and make sure that the choice of infrastructure projects that we take on are those that are actually creating, long-term jobs and reduce poverty. The second thing that I would like to address is there should be a well-coordinated construction, maintenance, and rehab of infrastructure. It's not enough that you build and you don't maintain it, right? We've seen that in various infrastructure projects. So to answer that question in terms of quality, I think the construction is good, but the maintenance and rehab were lagging behind.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to invite the private sector actually to come in, invite experts from all over the world to actually partner with the Philippines. And I would always say, let's welcome them. Let's welcome the investors, but we also have to protect them because we're looking for a long-term operation of all this infrastructure.
I think the elephant in the room here is when you talk about high costs. Money goes to the project, but we know it's an open secret that a lot is funneled to corruption. Do we have estimates, engineer, how much more expensive building infrastructure in the Philippines is, and how much of that is on account of corruption?
Well, it's really a very serious topic on public infrastructure development. That's why I would always believe that when you partner with the private sector, and the private sector actually, is in charge of their profit and loss, then less corruption will be on those infrastructure projects. Now, with the government and with the current administration trying to push for more projects and saying, we have to lessen the level of corruption, we welcome that. But I think the private sector, and we believe in the integrity in construction in the private sector, should be passed on also to the practice of public construction.
Mm-hmm. All right. Lots of things to unpack, engineer. We hope to have you back again for even more detailed conversation on this topic. It's going to be a big one for this year because of the Build Better More initiative. Thank you so much for joining us today. We'll see you
soon. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.